Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, back to Universe Mode. We are here with SmackDown Live, and my oh my, have I got a night for you. We will see eight of SmackDown Live's best competitors as they face each other in a battle royale over the top rope elimination match for the chance to challenge AJ Styles at Payback on the SmackDown side. So, let's get into the entrances without further ado. So here we go. This is exciting. Kicking off SmackDown Live with the first of two matches with an 8-man elimination battle royal. This is something that has never been done before. One to kick off Raw, and well, not kick off Raw, but main event Raw, but this to kick off SmackDown. You know the talent here is loaded. And here we have Shinsuke Nakamura, the man who has had a change of heart recently. The man who has been absolutely attacking, ruining AJ Styles' life, you could say. He has been attacking AJ Styles down, you know, what's up. So this is going to be fun. Shinsuke Nakamura has a brand new attitude. Quite frankly, I'm loving it. Shinsuke has every chance here to win this battle royal and gain another opportunity to face AJ and possibly win that title. So Shinsuke Nakamura, where can we even begin? The match he had last night with AJ Styles was good. It was a very safe battle from both competitors, and it just so happened in the end that AJ wanted that much more, and that was that. And unfortunately, Shinsuke Nakamura once again can't, you know, he couldn't do it against Jinder Mahal in the 3 months I think that he had. He couldn't do it in the 3 month build up to study AJ Styles. Maybe Shinsuke is not, you know, maybe he is just a B plus player. Maybe he's not supposed to win the big one, so we'll see about that. But with this new change of attitude, you know, Shinsuke could have something really special here. Not really caring about the crowd as much, being more sneaky, being more, you know, slimy and slithery, almost Viper-esque, you could say. So, but as far as we know, Randy Orton believes there's only one Viper and one Snake in the WWE, and that is him. So he will be in this match against his former partner, Shinsuke Nakamura. So we may look to see what Randy Orton thinks about that, about this new attitude change. And Shinsuke looks like he is ready for war here tonight. He looks like, with this new attitude, I believe he may actually win this match. Now, for the rest of the other competitors, I'm not too sure about, but we do have Shinsuke Nakamura, Randy Orton, John Cena. They're the only three that I will tell you about, and the rest will be, you know, as a surprise. So that's all I'm telling you. Shinsuke, Randy, and John Cena, they're the three. Now, I will not tell you about any others. You will have to watch them as the entrances come out. And just, I guess, hopefully the superstars I picked for the opportunity to go against AJ Styles really does warm your heart. And you maybe they'll get a pop when you see them come out. Maybe not. Who cares? You know, I'm only kidding. Right, let's do it now. Shinsuke Nakamura is about to finish off his entrance here. And we will see the second man who will take part in this battle royal. So, guys, I'm super excited for the SmackDown side of things here for Payback. So this could be fun. This may be a lot of fun. So Shinsuke is ready. He is waiting in the ring. You know, Shinsuke has a very, very long entrance. Like, what is that? What the hell is going on there? I wouldn't really like to ask him at the minute. So let's get into it, baby. Come on. Who is the second man taking part in our battle royal? Oh, the suspense may be killing you guys. This is fun. This is going to be a lot of fun. This match is going to be chaotic. And just think of it like this, guys. We have another match after this as well. The main event, AJ Styles versus a mystery opponent. I cannot proclaim who that is. But the second man is Rusev. So happy Rusev Day. I hope you're all having a very good Rusev Day wherever you are in the world. And don't forget to subscribe, of course. It's right up there in the left-hand corner. Don't forget to subscribe. Thank you, guys. If you want more Universe Mode, leave a like and subscribe, and I'll definitely do that. Here we go. Rusev, who also did not have a very good WrestleMania, lost in the fatal four-way. So we all know Rusev is looking to get a shot at that WWE title, and he could very well be the man to actually beat AJ Styles. He's got the size. He's got the tenacity. He's got the resiliency and he's also got the athleticism to do it. Let's not forget, this is a... He's close to a... He's a pretty heavy dude, but he's made... We can't speak English, we're too goddamn excited. He is mostly muscle, so... He's also gone a bit nuts. So, he's a bit unhinged. So we may look to see what he's going to do with that. So, this is going to be a good match. I'm excited to see who wants this more. Who wants to pull this match out of the bag and actually get themselves a win here tonight. Either way, facing off against AJ Styles isn't going to be too much fun for whoever wins. But here we go. My dark horse in this match. The extreme of the extreme, the underdogs. Ty Dillinger, Mr. Perfect 10. He's getting a chance here in this Battle Royal to go against AJ Styles. This guy is my dark horse. He's the guy that could possibly win all this. You know, he's fast. He's got ring smarts. He's savvy. He had a very, very good performance in the Andre Memorial Battle Royale on Sunday night in WrestleMania. So I think he was in the last 5 or 6. So, you know, he could be a very well Perfect 10 in this match here if he gets this win. And him and AJ Styles, that'll create an incredible match. No matter what the stipulation, no matter how it all plays out, he could very well be the man to beat AJ Styles, as could any man really in this Battle Royal. So, here we go, this is it now. The Perfect 10, I believe, has the best opportunity to win this match. I do really feel like, you know, when you finally see the 8 competitors and you really see them all meshed together, which is what we're going to see here now in a couple of minutes, it could be a very, very hard match for some of the people to get Ty Dillinger, you know, over the top rope, I'd say, because he's super smart. Look at that, like, the concentration in his face. He's waiting for whoever wants to come out next, and you guys can hear that music, so I'm assuming you guys know who that is. It is Mr. John Cena. He did not have the best of WrestleManias. He had a very, very disappointing loss to The Undertaker. So John Cena's looking for redemption. He's looking for... He's in a very tough predicament here, is Big Match John. Big Match John hasn't really been Big Match John in a couple of years, so... I think the last time Big Match John was... What he was at Royal Rumble 2017 when he beat AJ Styles, so you know that he has a chance to get the WWE title back if he wins this Battle Royal, but he's not just going up against one man, he's going up against another 7, so he's really going to have to knuckle down in this match and use his ring smarts. You know, he's got 2 Royal Rumble wins underneath his belt. He's won his fair matches here in Battle Royals, so if he can win one more, he gets the big one. He gets to become Big Match John again, with a chance to beat AJ Styles. So here we go. Who is the next guy to enter the ring? Oh, guys, I'm so excited for this side of this match. Like, the Raw Battle Royale was great, it was, but the competitors in this match have me so happy, like, you have no idea. So I'm chuffed about this now. So let's see who is next to enter the Battle Royal. Who is it? Whoa! Samoa Joe, another man who's been traded from Raw to SmackDown. That's a big, big, big signing there by SmackDown. Samoa Joe could win this entire thing, and he is no stranger to being able to choke people out. So AJ Styles could be in a lot of danger here. If Joe wins this match and he gets a one-on-one with him at a Payback, he might as well count it all out and give the title to Joe, because Joe has been a man on a mission the last couple of, you know, last couple of weeks in WWE. He returned last week, so he's, you know, he's got a different bit of an attitude about him. So he's a lot more focused, is what I will say. You can see Shinsuke Nakamura, John Cena, and Rusev out there all having a little chat. You can really tell that John Cena needs this. You know, he needs this more than anybody, because this is his life, this is his livelihood, this is what he needs. So. But Samoa Joe was like, hey, you want to win that match? Here's a line, let's go do it. So here we go now. Samoa Joe, center of the ring, ready for war. Who is the next man? I believe this is the 6th competitor, I believe. 6th or 5th. Who is it? The lights go off. Samoa stands in the darkness. Samoa Joe stands in darkness as smoke fills the oil and around the ring. It's a member of Sanity, but... Which member of Sanity is it? They were only called up to the main roster there during the Superstar Shake-Up. And I have given one of them the opportunity of a lifetime. And it is Killian Dane. A Irish native son of my own as well. He's from Belfast. So, obviously he's northern, I'm south. But tonight, Killian is representing Ireland. And he's going to try to represent it as well as possible with a win. He wants to be only the third man in history, I believe it is, for the Irish to become a champion. First was Sheamus, second was Finn, and now we have Killian Dane. Obviously Becky Lynch, of course, she's in the women's category there. She was the SmackDown Women's Champion, but she is the female women's, obviously. So Killian's looking to be the third man to do it. So can Killian be the guy? In my opinion, he weighs the much. He weighs half of two superstars in this match. So Killian could very well get this win. Now he's a rookie on the main roster. You know, this is his first match on the main roster. A lot of pressure on this kid. So at the minute, he doesn't look like he's feeling the pressure. He's giving us his whole Sanity entrance. So, and guys, for those of you who also didn't catch it as well on the Raw side, I am officially stating it now. This is an official statement again, if you guys didn't catch it on the last episode. But 205 Live is being scrapped. We're sending all those competitors to NXT for a bigger NXT roster. Never really a fan of 205 Live. I think it's amazing what they can do in the ring, but I want to put them up against the likes of Johnny Gargano, you know, Roderick Strong. Well, obviously Roderick Strong's already there, but Tommaso Ciampa. So that is gonna be fun. Also, I've got a brand new NXT champion, and you guys have to wait until the next episode to actually see who that guy is. So yeah, this is something special. This is something special for Killian Dane. He looks like he's feeling the nerves, and he should. Oh, he's playing to the crowd, but paying no attention as he realizes that Mr. Randy Orton has just came out from the curtain. And this man could be the guy to do it. This is the man who has won a Royal Rumble himself. This is the man who is 6'4", close to 240 pounds, chiseled out of stone, can strike you from anywhere, can make the match grueling, can make it easy for you, put you out of your misery when you want. This guy is my pick. I am choosing on record right now, this is the guy that wins this Battle Royal. Randy Orton is my pick. And if Randy Orton doesn't win, Killian Dane's my second pick. So let's do it now. This is good. I believe after Randy Orton, there's one more man to enter the match. And I believe the crowd will pop for this man. I believe that this man could also win the match, but size I don't feel. But Randy Orton had a very, very horrible WrestleMania where he lost the United States Championship to Jinder Mahal. But we already know that Jinder has vacated that, and he vacated for a chance to go and face Brock Lesnar in the Battle Royale, and he didn't win. So Jinder Mahal is now with no title, and obviously Seth is the Intercontinental Championship champion on Raw, excuse me. So Jinder may look to get in a match there at some stage. But who is the eighth and final man? Who is it? Come on, it is Daniel Bryan. Could you imagine? Just picture this, okay? So it's Payback, WWE 2K18 Universe mode. Daniel Bryan, AJ Styles, one-on-one for the WWE Championship. That's a dream match. That is right there. I know the fans would love that. I would love that. I don't think there's anybody on planet Earth that wouldn't love that match. But for that to happen, Daniel has got to win this match. He's got to stay smart. He's had a lot of time out of the ring. He's only had one match, I think. So he's only had the Shane McMahon versus Kevin Owens and Sami Zayn match. And in real life, he's also had the AJ Styles match as well. But this is not real. So this is his first match on my Universe mode. It's a lot of for the first matches, but it's everyone's first match. But it's really Daniel Bryan's return kind of match to his brand. So can Daniel Bryan win this match, outlast seven of the toughest men in WWE today? We're about to see as things kick off here. Samoa Joe's already in a bit of trouble here from Shinsuke Nakamura. Shinsuke's got him up. Randy Orton with a nice neck breaker there on Daniel Bryan. But Jesus, all rivalries are kind of settling out here. Rusev and John Cena as well going at it. Shinsuke and Samoa Joe. Those two would have a great one-on-one if it ever came down to it. Of course, Randy Orton and Samoa Joe is another one we'd all love to see. And this is fun now. I'd also like to see Randy Orton and Killian Dane. That would be a really good match as well. Very technical. So here we go now. The perfect 10 Ty Dillinger. It's got Killian Dane again. Oh my god, Shinsuke Nakamura's out. Shinsuke Nakamura just got eliminated from this match. We're only in this match about a minute and a half, a minute and 15 seconds. Shinsuke's gone. I cannot believe that. Samoa Joe is not playing around today. Ty Dillinger. Ty Dillinger may be out. Ty, he hangs on. Okay, fair play to him, he hangs on. Ty is doing his best. Fights off Killian Dane and Samoa Joe. Something that Shinsuke could not do. Daniel Bryan has been eliminated.
Nice job by Samoa Joe.
And Killian Dane hangs on. Killian's still in there. The rookie, the main event, I can't even speak. I'm too excited. It's crazy. Ty Dillinger hangs on. I cannot believe that Daniel Bryan got eliminated that quick. Everyone's getting eliminated pretty quick opposed to the Raw side. John Cena, he hangs on. This is exciting. This is dead exciting.
Great offense by Rusev.
Killian Dane's got a hold of Randy Orton here.
That packed a punch.
Randy could be out here if this happens. And Randy's out! Killian Dane eliminates Randy Orton. Guys, we've down to 5 superstars already. What? Got Ty Dillinger, the perfect 10, is still in there. Killian Dane with a very perfect. Oh my god. Samoa Joe has been eliminated by Ty Dillinger. What? Excuse me? Killian Dane and Ty Dillinger are having great performances. They're proving they can hang. It's incredible. And Rusev is in danger here. Can Big Match John eliminate Rusev? That'd be a sight to see. Not at the minute. Rusev hangs on. He knows he has a good chance to win if he can stay in there. But John is just... What happened? Okay. Rusev got back in there. He's going back to John. Ty Dillinger. Ty, hang on, Ty. Ty Dillinger has been eliminated. Rusev has been eliminated. We are down to 2. John Cena and Killian Dane. Killian's first. He's just been called up from NXT. Oh my god, this is incredible. If Killian could pull this off. Wait a second. Big Match John with AA. Did he just fake an AA? Oh, that was beautiful. He faked an AA into a carry and then AA'd him. Big Match John is switching it up here tonight.
Just carrying the opposition.
He's got Killian up here on his shoulders. Maybe looking for the elimination? No. Face first into the turnbuckle. Killian Dane is one-on-one with John Cena. This is insane. He's actually in the final too. Oh, beautiful fireman's carry into a slam. This is insane from Killian Dane. If he can get the win, he would face AJ Styles on his first night and become a man to ever. Oh my god, I can't even speak, guys. This is too exciting. John Cena looks to wear down Killian Dane to get his heavy load over the top rope, I guess. Killian's got the size advantage, obviously the weight advantage, but does John Cena have the strength? At the minute, he's just going blow for blow. He's throwing out a lot of kicks, a lot of shots. He doesn't want to tussle up with Killian Dane. Maybe a bit. Oh my god, Killian's been busted open again. Killian has been busted open. Kind of the same thing that happened to Baron Corbin, where the blood went into his eyes and he couldn't stop the elimination from Kevin Owens. Nice slam there by Killian. Landed right on John Cena's midsection. Trying to take the wind out of John Cena. Here we go. He's got John Cena up in a carry. John Cena maybe. No. John Cena slides off the back and attacks the back of the legs, injuring Killian Dane again. Big Match John is not letting this one go. He wants this win. He does, he really wants this. Has Killian up against the ropes. What's he going to go for here? Killian's it. No. Killian hangs on. Fair play to Killian Dane. He's hung on more than most people did in this whole match. But John Cena, got him up on the shoulders. Not sure how smart it is of John Cena to put all that weight on his shoulders, but either way, it pays off for himself. John Cena needs to stay away from that. You know, picking up Killian Dane as much as possible. Putting a lot of strain on his shoulders. On his back, his neck, his spine. He needs to, even his legs, you know, to lift. He's got to cut that out. He's got to stay focused on his quick moves and keep Killian Dane. Keep him moving. You know, here we go again. Look, I don't really agree with this. this could be a problem for John Cena's back. Look, that one took a little bit longer to get Killian off, but it was a successful AA. This could be Killian Dane. He's got life. He's breathing. His face is a crimson mess, but he's trying to get in there. I think I'm getting reports that the blood is actually in Killian Dane's eyes. Killian Dane may be fighting blind here, but he's got John Cena up. Can he get him? John Cena's teetering on that top rope here. Killian may become the next number one contender. Oh, John Cena with a shot to the back. What is this now? A front sit-out slam from John Cena. Killian Dane is fighting blind here, guys. The blood, I'm being told, in my earpiece is running into his eyes. So Killian is actually fighting with next to no sight. So this is all hard from Killian Dane here. This is incredible. John Cena with another beautiful slam. So this may be just a matter of time before John actually gets the win. Oh, but wait a minute. Killian Dane got the reversal. And John Cena with the reversal again. And the punch takes down Killian. So the member of Sanity here is having a spot of bother. What is going to happen here? This is exciting. Come on, John. Come on, Killian. What's up? Beautiful lifting neck breaker by John Cena. It's been a long time since we've seen that. John Cena's pulled out all the stops. Big Match John wants that title. He wants AJ Styles. He's got Killian up again. And another slam. You can really tell he's working Killian's back. He really wants him to suffer in this again. What's this, John? Another sit-out slam. John Cena could have probably ended this a long time ago. At the end of the day, Killian is fighting blind, so you kind of got to feel bad. It's just a mistake, and here we go. John Cena with the one leg, trying to get Killian out. Killian, he's teetering. John Cena could be number one contender. Killian, Sanity member is out of here. Killian Dane is out, and John Cena is your new number one contender for the WWE Championship against AJ Styles at Payback. So we've got our two main events set there already. We've got Brock Lesnar, the Universal Champion from the Raw side, taking on Kevin Owens. And we also have John Cena from the SmackDown side taking on AJ Styles for the WWE Championship. Two great main events there. Killian could not get... He couldn't do it, you know? It was just too much for him on the main stage. But listen, he performed well to himself and he'll be back. He's just a rising guy. He was in the final two with John Cena after outlasting six of WWE's most hardest individuals. Now, guys, I've got one more match for you, and it's AJ Styles versus a mystery opponent. I have high hopes for the next coming match, and I hope you guys do too. And look at John Cena there, celebrating his win, knowing that in 4 weeks he has a date with Destiny. He could become a 17-time WWE champion and surpass Ric Flair's legendary record. Well, guys, that is 4 weeks away, so let's get into our main event of SmackDown Live. Here we go. AJ Styles is going to be in action, and he's got a chance to actually look and see how John Cena got on in his match. So now John Cena's going to get a chance to look at AJ Styles one-on-one with this mystery opponent. And there you see AJ Styles, WWE champion. Now, I know that I've been told in my earpiece that AJ Styles was backstage during that match watching it on the TV monitor. And he was watching how John Cena, you know, he competed in a multi-man match. Said he was very impressed. So he's looking forward to his four-week build-up with John Cena and then finally getting to have it all culminate in what could be an amazing main event. We'll look forward to that. But I've just also been told that John Cena has told our producers that he is looking forward to seeing AJ Styles compete in a singles match to get a feel for how AJ likes to run his singles matches, because you've got to remember, it's been a while since John Cena has had a chance to do that. So this should be fun, you know? Guys, please excuse that phone call there. I'm a very, very busy man, you know? Yeah, here we go. AJ Styles in a singles match against a mystery opponent. So let's see just how good AJ Styles can be. Once again, post-WrestleMania. And I'm also being told that it's been a man that has been traded from Raw to SmackDown. So it's a fresh face on SmackDown Live here. Someone that AJ Styles has wrestled pretty in his first couple of nights on SmackDown Live. It's been a while, so. And it is none other than The Miz. The Hollywood movie star, if you want to say. But The Miz is also your United States champion. I needed to pick a guy that I believe that would make it relevant again, and The Miz is the guy. When Jinder relinquished it, I had people banging down my door looking for that championship, and I went with The Miz. He was a fresh face. It's going to cause a lot of controversy, yes, I know. But it is champion versus champion here. It's the WWE champion versus the United States champion. Two men at the top level of the game going one-on-one in singles action. Any man could get a win here in this match, and I'm looking forward to this. AJ Styles rolls out of the ring, possibly to give The Miz the respect that he thinks he deserves, to have a little glow. Now this should be fun. Could you imagine if The Miz defeats AJ Styles here tonight? Well, I think that would mean that The Miz may be going to have a triple threat match with AJ Styles, John Cena, and The Miz. That could be a triple threat if The Miz pulls this off here tonight. But to be honest with you, I think we're kind of hoping for that that one-on-one feel. So I think AJ Styles deserves that one-on-one feel. I am pumped. Here we go. AJ Styles and The Miz one-on-one, and the bell has begun. Let's get into it. Both men tie up. AJ Styles with the front headlock. Here we go. He's cranking it on The Miz. He's letting The Miz know, hey, welcome to SmackDown Live, baby. This is the house that AJ Styles built. And he's in another position here now. Styles trips him. Kind of giving The Miz a bit of a wrestling lesson. A little chop there. But The Miz with a nice go behind. A nice takedown. Ankle only takedown. That was nice by The Miz. Miz has got AJ Styles up to a knee. What's he going for here? Dropping those hands on him. DDT. Beautiful DDT. The Miz is going up. Second rope early enough.
Don't you dare get up, man.
Asking AJ Styles to get up. And a beautiful double axe handle slam. AJ Styles rolls out. Rolls out of the ring. The Miz has got AJ rocked here in the early going and knocks him down. Now The Miz has to be careful here. He cannot win the match. He cannot win via count out. He can realistically if he's back in the ring, but at the minute, if I'm Styles, I'm just going to beat down The Miz till about a count of 7 or 8 and take myself back into that ring, and I'm going to get the win. There you go. Nice knee to the back. There you go. There you go. That'll work out The Miz's his back problems there from. Beautiful clothesline. Every move that AJ Styles is doing here now is very, very effective on the outside. That's what I'm witnessing in anyway. And he brings The Miz back into the ring. He wants to pin The Miz 1-2-3. So, yeah, fair play to you, AJ. Ooh, the referee getting caught up with AJ there. AJ Styles is now egging The Miz on to get up, and he does. And a beautiful elbow from the second row. Styles is surveying the landscape. And wait a second, here's The Miz now. And The Miz cranking the arm off his shoulder. That could very well. Oh, wait a second. He's in position for the. Oh, beautiful. Beautiful move. I was about to say, The Miz looks like he's trying to take out the phenomenal forearm and even the Styles clash by hurting that shoulder, but Styles says there's nothing wrong with it here, watch me fly. So Styles with a beautiful forearm again, and there you go again. The Miz is attacking those legs. Is that the setup for a figure four, or is that to injure AJ Styles so he can't use it as a springboard for the phenomenal forearm? So this is all. Wait a second, what's this? Oshigoroshi. Got it. This could be it. Pin? No. It kicks him in the back.
Exactly,
okay.
What AJ Styles needed.
AJ Styles has taken control here. What's this now? Fireman's carry into a back slam. Goes for a pin off of that. One. Two. Oh, no. Miz kicking out of that. The Miz is saying, hey, that's not going to do it for me. You best believe. Styles look like she's setting up for something. Could be the phenomenal forearm. If Styles gets this, it could all be over. He connects. This could be it. One. Two. Three. That is it. AJ Styles wins the match. That was very impressive. The Miz got a bit of offense in on the early ons, but toward the last kind of half of the match, that was all AJ. He done a lot of moves, but 4 or 5 in quick succession without having any interruptions. And that was the shot there. Maybe the Miz just wasn't ready. Maybe the Miz was having an off day, you know? But either way, the Miz is still your United States champion. And what does this mean now that AJ Styles has defeated him, you know? What if John Cena beats AJ Styles at Payback? Does that mean that AJ Styles will be ready for an United States Championship match? Who knows? Guys, that'll wrap up SmackDown Live here. If you guys did enjoy the episode, please leave a like. Leave a like, comment, subscribe, as you guys can see in the left-hand corner there. And click that beautiful notification bell so you never, ever miss an episode. And I think we're off to a pretty good start in Universe mode. So, I guess, guys, I will see you in the next one.